the social, economic and cultural landscape of Blanchardstown has seen a dramatic change in the last 30 years. Tim Ryan, owner of Ryan's Garage in Blanchardstown Village, has been working in Blanchardstown since 1963.
At that time, all the traffic going to Navan and Cavan and Monaghan all came right through the village. And for years, we had really, it had got to such a state that all we were looking out at was trucks queuing up for the traffic lights, and there was a continuous jam up of traffic. Volume of people, the population has changed to such an extent that it's just hard to imagine. You know, we went from a sleepy village to one of the biggest changes in nearly Ireland. Dublin 15 now has had more houses built in it, I'd say, in the past 20 years than any other place in Ireland.
In the last 10 years, the Institute of Technology Blanchardstown has been a real centre for economic growth within the area.
It's a great experience, wide variety of different jobs.
Well, around here there's not much in the area that we're doing, so you won't have to go further afield to look for the jobs that you want.
1996, Blanchardstown was just a field. Well, it was a town, but it was more a field than anything else.
It's huge now. Like, you say somebody live in Blanchard, where do you live? Like, geez, you could place anywhere.
Obi Oji, a second year creative digital media student, tells us about his job prospects.
I believe there are a couple of good prospects for myself. For example, in Blanchard Village, I think there are many different areas which the courses which are in this college are preparing us for. I believe there are a couple of jobs available. For example, there's like something like a computer clubhouse down in Blanchardstown Village, and as multimedia artists we can have a job there teaching people how to use the different applications and different offerings we got in our course.
Mick Harford has lived in the Dublin 15 area for most of his 89 years.
But years ago, everyone was in everyone else's house or very near, they knew what was going on in everyone else's house, and they all helped one another. Now that nobody will help you anything, they won't even say good morning to you. Nowadays, you can't even cross the road. And opposite me there was no houses or anything there, only there for the last, 12, 14 years. It was a field. And in the back of me here, and the side of me, the college ground, those playing fields out there. Now there's a whole estate in it. What sort it is, I don't know. I haven't been in there since it opened.
Blanchardstown has gone through periods of boom and bust in the last 30 years, but what the future holds, only time will tell.